Welcome back to that same night from last time.
What's wrong with this?
Here's what's happening. I have been inspired.
The dude is only set to like
because I'm like, all right, I'll run a motor and we'll do a thing and then I'll come over there. Oh, but here's what I'm going to actually do. So
like
in the spirit of boats, because boats, I'm going to build the Titanic's engine, or what I think in my heart is the Titanic's engine, which is basically I'm going to take
what,
this
drift?
Plate, which is this
bounce?
Entire fucking stupid thing.
I had Zeus Drifty on and we were not drifting at all. We were fucking flying.
Yeah, no, it was pretty stable. I need a good base plate for a motor assembly.
It is actually handling way better
perfect.
Now.
Perfect. So this entire plate.
We have a there's a tool
the size of
that
the
I have on the server called friction,
and
it's
going to be
a
five or a six cylinder,
like the old school.
And
physical
it's
properties.
Not going to move with the boat. It's just going to crank hard.
Okay.
How hard?
Me
well,
and Zeos were testing it out. It freaks out on props that aren't make spherical.
I don't even know how
of
I'm going to
like touching
build
and untouching the
stability
ground,
into this
because
I want to
yeah,
make it out of wired weights.
Items, it works really, really well.
Here,
that push down with like 450,000 wired weights per cylinder, and I'll do like six cylinders across, five across, three echo, 360 divided by five.
Oh,
echo.
Forgot make spherical.
360 divided by five.
360
right,
divided by 5
I'm
is 72.
I could do that. As long as it isn't a weird number, I could do like a 5-cylinder. And I'm going to have to build individual crank components. So it'll basically be one part per. And then I could actually duplicate it. Oh, I don't even have to build more than one. Oh, shit. No. Oh, I know what I'm building. All right, I know what I'm building. I know what I'm building now. I know what I'm building. It's going to be an 8-cylinder. But not a V, it's going to be straight down, and we're going to have interlocking massive motherfucking gears as the crank components, so that the one side of the... Oh, my nipples. Oh, my nipples.
This sounds like old school you. I'm glad that you're feeling it.
Shut the fuck up and get on my server.
Oh, I did these backwards.
How do I start this? That's the worst part. So I should be able to build one section and then duplicate it three other times, which will be a lot better. No, it'll be a lot easier. It won't be better, but it'll be a lot easier. Okay, so let's see. Where are those gears that we were just, that Zotronic and I were just hunting down? So apparently you got to dig through the games, Gary's Mod, Mechanics, Gears
I'm hopping in.
Section.
Hold on.
Gears small, gears large. Like, that's the type of cranking gear that I'm talking about. Like that.
Yeah,
like here, hold on, let me stand on the floor. Like that size gear. In fact, that is actually the gear I'm probably going to use. I think there might be a bigger one. I know there's narrower ones. Yeah, there's narrower ones, but I think they're the same.
Shit, my axle upside.
Yeah, they're the same size. So let's just go with the fucking wider ones. My biggest concern now, well, here's the base plate, and we've discussed this already with it. You put a plate in the ground, you slam that weight to 50 grand, you never move it, you never unfreeze it, because its job is to just be, in fact, everything this motor is going to be like 50,000 weight.
Just like rolling over.
I can do fucking 10 of them, look how wide this is. And I'll probably build like a structure around this once it's done. But I really need to.
This thing is obnoxious.
I hate this texture. This texture is.
I need to see this from like outside. Oh my god.
Oh no. No. Is that a rug?
You know, that's exactly how my F-150 drove on the racetrack.
Screams.
Pulling the rear tire up off the ground.
Yeah, it's because you got no.
I'm not
gonna
make
back.
It clear. I'm just gonna make
so,
it darker.
Let's just
there
put a fucking
go.
Weight in the
nice rusty one.
I have roll bars on my truck up there.
Is there a weight?
Are they driving? I didn't see them. So
no, there isn't. It's a wire weight, isn't it?
What? No, there's a weight tool.
Yeah, no, there's a.
If
like
I do
a
10, an 8 or a 10.
A ballast tool.
I can make it so smooth if I make it a 10. I can make it so fucking smooth.
So I'm just gonna fucking.
Alright, well, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna use a balloon for an actual good reason now, and not just for safety reason. We're gonna make the rope nice and long. Make it really strong, and we're gonna pop down.
Oh my god, these are all like
dead center.
Really lightweight. Holy shit. Okay, your actually, your we're gonna chassis make that rope, and stuff is.
I can higher. Can change the thickness of the rope. That's stupid. I can change the thickness of the rope. Anyway, that's just gonna be our marker. That's basically
the easy weld,
a reverse plumb up. Yeah, you just use
precision. Yeah, you have to use precision.
And I'm only doing that so I have to line up the gear.
Right click easy
for dead center.
Oh my god, why is it rotating?
I don't want to make it too close to the ground, but I'm not going to have it float midair since we are pushing downward. I'm getting a feeling that dropping like 200,000 weight on a cylinder, which is going to have to be a constrained cylinder. I'm thinking like you can't use a slider. That's known. It's not going to be a slapper, so I'm not using an axis. It's going to have to just be.
I kind of wish I had a setting for the hydraulics that they weren't just fucking stuck.
I think how I'm gonna
did
do
you
that.
Make them out of hydraulics?
I know what I'm gonna do yeah. with the bottom already. I just don't know what I'm doing with the top. And that's perfectly fine. So let's see.
So just adjust them.
That rope is the middle. I'm just trying to get this here. And then I'm going to do stacker.
I'm just gonna make a stacker number.
Left. Yes. And we're gonna bring it back to where I think it needs to be. And we gotta move this whole prop over.
Constant value. Where the fuck is constant value?
You gotta go to the gates. There's a separate gates thing that you have to, like, dig through.
Yeah, but where is gates? Where is
the...
There it is.
Got it. Alright, alright. So I do that. Are those welded together? No. Okay, so those are... two basically centered props. We got a little bit of a gap underneath, probably like a foot. That's fine. This is some old school building. It's not as precision as, you know, like someone could fucking define the points and do the burr burr burr. But I'm gonna go right click, right click, right click, right click. Actually, I'm probably not gonna do this where I build multiple and then duplicate it. I'll build like one master one. Oh, I set them to no collide one another. Can I undo that no collide? Because I stackered it with no collision on. Nope, cannot. And I just undid the fucking thing instead of. Ah, no! Okay, Garry's Mod. It's just Garry's Mod. It's just Garry's Mod. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. We have to redo all the work we did because you fucked up because you left the goddamn no collide on and you can't do that when you're stackering gears to work. Jackass.
Okay. Oh, this will work.
Of course it's fucking not. And I think I had it somewhere like... it was actually pretty far out into the gear. Alright, should I stack it one more time? I'm sure the orientation is going to be fucked up, and of course it is. That's left, so now I'm going to try down. Nope, I'm going to try.
Oh, there we go.
Perfect. Behind. Yes, it's behind. We're going to shut off no collide.
So this is.
Send it, Nick.
We are that's real stock. Close to that. How's our gapping on the floor?
That's low lift.
We're totally maybe like right 3 inches off the floor now instead of a foot.
There you go.
I guess that'll be fine. We'll find out, boys and girls.
Now go do donuts.
Do the axis again. It's really dark here. Like this brown prop on these brown gears. God. I need to change the color of these gears, just so I can fucking see them. That might be too clear.
That looks ridiculous.
Perfect. Perfect. Absolutely.
But
great.
It's pretty stable for how not stable it is.
Glass gears.
How does it do with a vending machine in the back, though?
Oh, great! The exact same color. That's perfect.
I made the bed all by fucking five.
That's oh my god! Just give me a fucking normal like light.
If it was welded to the frame, it'd be fine. But if it's on the bed, it's not going to do anything. It's just going to fall.
Okay, so now I've done the axis. Did I do the axis? Did I do the axis?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Like, alright, I'm just gonna touch this one and see if it falls off. It does not. I did the access.
Sure.
Always with gears, you make them super ice. I'm gonna leave gravity on for now. I might change that later. Because you don't want them to... Yeah. You want to grease your gears. You want to grease your gears. You want to slide. Slide. Slide.
It fits, though.
This is not the fucking...
So...
The actual one I'm making. This was the first model, which is like...
Just like a mock-up.
It's too large.
I like the use of triangles for this bed.
So many tools I'm switching through.
Triangles when I'm making some stuff over here.
A flashlight?
Yeah. Got the hood done, okay. I think.
Alright, so now I'm going to freeze both of these. And we're dead center. That's what the balloon was for. Thank you, balloon. You've done your job. And now we're going to stack her left and right. We could weld them, actually. Because...
Nick, that's terrifying.
No, I'll weld them later. Don't weld them now. Just get them in place.
I'm watching from over here.
Down. It's down. It's reset. We're going to give two to the right.
You want
to
see the smaller one? Like the actual one that I'm working
on? And we're actually going to count two, not three. Two. We're gonna give a nice wide berth between these things because it's gonna be a fucking trip. If I can go 40 on the nose, that's
the worst thing about making.
If you could round off the numbers, that's
makes it hard to grab shit.
One, two, and then go up. Three, four. So there. Oh, by the way, it's gonna be a straight 10, not an 8, because I can fit it. So fuck you.
Nice.
So now we have to go back and we have to access all of these to the base. One. Two. And I made sure I gapped them big enough so I could walk between them and do things like this, because God knows I'm going to be walking through this fucking motor. We're also going to have to unfreeze this all and test it because...
Oh, wow. It'll be more stable, too.
I'm doing things between props, and I can never tell if I'm actually, like, clipped into something else, and maybe none of that's working. And we should be able to return all these to center anyway. But let's... Physical properties... Fuck it, take gravity off. We're not going to need gravity since I'm sitting still. I know what I'm going to end up doing to it anyway. Hell, I'm even going to take that off. Just the floor, in case it gets crushed into the floor. Thank you, Mr. Balloon. Balloons do a great thing in this game. So yeah, this is gonna be two straight fives, literally sitting next to each other, but then I'll be able to time it like a 10 cylinder. Because I could have one, two, I don't have to fire two at the same time. I can fire them individual for perfect smoothness. And I'm gonna weld straight down both of these. So that they'll act, that's my crank. Like, I could put a visual thing through the middle if you really want me to, but I don't really feel like doing that. So when I stop that, all of it will stop. Unless, oh shit! You know what I just realized? I could put wire weld latches between all these sections of crank, and then I could have it just be a two-cylinder. But then it wouldn't be firing correctly, so I really shouldn't do that. No, that's dumb. It's fine. I'm gonna make it 10. So now the next step of this fucking plan, because the motors are real easy to build. It's a matter of, like, not having them freak the fuck out. And that's going to require us building something different. Let's go back up to cylinder. I think we hear, like, what's in Varus? Let's look up. What is that? That's a can of soda. Okay, great. Solid steel. I think I tried to build motors out of these once, because that is literally a hollow prop that you could have something ride up and down in. It's just, you know,
oh my god.
Robotics large, like, I mean, I would use, like, this thing as the crank. Boom. I've built motors with this thing as the crank. And even this is like maybe I'd put this.
Hey, you want to see the greatest thing ever?
Oh, it doesn't fit. Doesn't fit. Never mind. And I'm definitely not going to use physical things, which is going to use ropes.
Are you going to climb this?
One less thing to fail. Cylinders.
I can't believe that just worked.
I'm trying to think
how we actually drove up that. That's ridiculous. I'm
trying to think how to do this.
Watch this. Dead.
Look what I could do. I just had to play with some props now.
Hold on.
So let's see. Garry's Mod balloons, mechanics, articulating. Oh man, imagine if this was the crank. Imagine if every one of these had this on the cylinder. Hold me back, bro. Hold me back. That would be fucking awesome looking. But like the axis would fail. Because then you'd be adding an extra, like a rope, a wired rope. Or a rope, not a wire rope. Like a rope.
Are you home now, Alberto, or are you still home? No, you're definitely home.
Hold on, wait.
Yeah,
his wife's like hugging him and shit, unless she's in the truck.
No, I'm home.
If you do a rigid rope between two things like this, look. See this rope? That's basically a imaginary physical prop with ball sockets. So you pick one up, and it's just like, look, let's just, there you go. There's your ball socket. Two ball socketed props. But there's no mass. There's no freak out. Ropes are the most reliable tool in Garry's Mod. Rigid ropes are, that's it. You literally can create sticks with ball sockets on the end of it. And it's fucking beautiful. And the problem is, if I wanted to do like a physical prop, like that fucking thing to be part of the engine, I'd need 10 of these. And then I'd need two constraints because I wouldn't just, I need an axis and an axis. And then you're talking about the weight of this has to be high enough so that the axes don't fail. Well, the wire rope, the rope doesn't care about weight. It's one of the few things that doesn't care. So I'd want to so bad, but I can't. I can't do it. So what we're going to do is we're going to get some cylinders out because we have plenty of tubes. I think we're not going to go with super thin because just for reasons. We know exactly that. If I attach the rope to the top of one of these, that to that is this throw that the engine's going to make. So all I got to do is find a cylinder that's slightly longer than that. And that will literally be our cylinder.
Tricky.
And there's our cylinder.
How is that thing even balancing half of the time?
I'm gonna undo all of these props I spawned. So what is that? A 60 by 90?
Almost all of the weight is below the top of the wheel.
Or 60 by 96? They seriously did that? Why so many? Alright, we'll do 60 by 96 because that's 8 feet. So now Knutson. Bring this over. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use precision alignment on this.
Yeah, what I was going
to
do.
To place this. Because I want this directly over like a center set of gears. So let's put them back in place. And then I'll stack her back and forth.
That doesn't work with the fucking machine.
Okay, so real easy. Precision alignment. Mass center. Clear the points that I had because I use it for that shit. So just delete all points. We could leave the line. We still have that line somewhere floating around here. Yeah, right here. You can see that blue line. In case I need it. But now we need a mass point center there. And point two. Mass point center there. And then we can move it into it. See, the problem I have now is collisions.
The chances we can get ACF put in this.
Because we got right there.
We do have ACF.
We do have ACF.
My dick's hurt.
I don't want to make anything bigger than this as far as diameter. Well, I really should, before I decide on this, I should find the prop that I'm going to use for this.
We should have ACF because I can piston.
Because I might need to go thicker.
Yep.
If you have it.
Alright, right before here. We move on, let me open up a can of whoop ass. What do we got? Tubes 48. What is this? That was a tube's 60 by 90, right? 60 by 96. So this is a tube I want to use.
An air feed tube.
No, sorry. You don't have ACF tricky.
Yeah, no, I don't. This is
it's hard
72
to,
by 96.
Hard to hear what he's saying. What's that?
He said he doesn't. He's seeing an error.
And then
but you can see
84
it.
By 96.
Yeah, I could see it.
Of course, I mean, I could fit anything. As long as I find the right prop, the wider we go with the cylinder, the easier
well,
to be ripped off
sideways.
Well, that makes
my job a lot easier, I'm going to fuck around making a giant laggy ass.
I'm building an engine for my truck. I have to go old school.
Like, you can't go with a flat plate.
There we go.
Like, you just fucking
can't. That's what's going to run my truck. 62 horsepower.
One of
that's
these
how much
would be
power
great.
My ATV is.
If there was a solid cylinder that wasn't like the size of a fucking soda can, like it'd be fantastic. But there isn't. So I'd have to go find like a barrel or something. Something that I could put in here and I know that when I freak it out with 50,000 weight, it's not going to twist over and do bad shit. So let's see. Let's see. Articulating, no. It could be a gear. Like I could put a big fat gear in there. Oh, I said a big fat gear. Large. Even if it's a gear, like just having it like fit would be fantastic. I mean, that fucking fits. You'd obviously have to super ice it, and it would have a little bit of a bang. I still feel like this is gonna break. This whole thing's gonna break.
Yeah, I got it installed.
I understand what I understand what failure is.
What? ACF is installed.
Do you have ACF mobility or whatever?
How do I do this?
I have a weird jank workshop version of it that's like not official, but it's part of the collection that I have on the.
How do I do this?
Okay, that might be it.
Yeah, it's
I think I've installed ACF.
Advanced combat frames, yeah. There we go. Okay.
Make it a V and use the weight of it sliding against the side.
It's still there. Probably gonna reload.
Yeah, start reloading.
Sliders. Can't use sliders.
My balloon!
Let me see something. Hold on a second. How small do our tubes get? Because maybe I'm thinking too big. Maybe I gotta think smaller. Like, it's huge already, and the concept's already there, but... Geometry? We have rings. You have rings.
I'm gonna be working basically all day tomorrow.
I wanna try to do this with less props.
Actually, if I start at 3:30...
Oh, shit.
I'm gonna have to go until 5:30. I'm hoping to be somewhere that I can fucking park and get fuel and get a shower. And, not do anything for a day.
I don't think this goes through. I think this just fits on top. I don't think that'll fall down around it. Yeah, no, it's not gonna. And even if it could, it's just like... Thought maybe I could build, like, a fucking seal around the cylinders. No, that's not gonna... It's not gonna like this, is it? No, so 60 is it's meant to cap it, but not meant to slide around a 60. So, that's out.
What else
we got? 48, 42.
Oh, that was me. Hold on.
48, 60, 72, 84. None of them are close enough. Maybe like a 90 and a 96. No, they don't even do 90. Well, they do a 96. Wait a second.
Three errors.
They do a 96, and I think one of these tubes is a 90. Wait, no, I think it's 90 length.
One error.
The ACF is kind of weird.
It could be if maybe he has a...
It's too much gap.
Like a legit version installed already, and
my
workshop
hurt.
Version is just...
Tense up your butt cheeks. You gotta keep your butt
his
going
unhappy
numb.
Or something.
Could I use spheres? Oh my god. Could I make the spheres... Could I make a wire weight into a sphere? That's a thing we used to be able to do, is define our own custom wire weight models. I would have to figure out the console command for that.
I'm just gonna post it in the Telegram. I remember this in particular having to go here and download it and then.
What was that? that? That was a 48? 60? Okay, because here's what I'm thinking. That would be the ultimate way to do this. Is a little bit of bounce. I could negate that bounce slightly. I'd have to have some help with this shit, though. I mean, it wouldn't matter. I could use a smaller one at that point. And if I really want to make it tight, what I would do is... Let me see if I can show you here. I would... So we've got a ball, right? If I make the wire weight that I'm going to control spawn as the fucking...
Oh my god.
Sphere, I could define whatever a wire weight prop model is. Then I could find the center of it with precision alignment, which will allow me to attach a rope to it to use as the piston. Hold on, I'm brainstorming. Where are you?
I solved the problem.
There's a sphere. I could just spin around all the fucking ones. Where?
You see this can?
I see the can.
Back up.
Yeah, but does that change its physical diameters?
Yes.
Oh shit.
No. Yes. It's kind of iffy, it seems. Yeah, it's fine.
Can you dupe it now? Dupe it. Spawn a block in the ground, then dupe it.
Yeah. It looks weird in the
How does it do that?
There is a tool called prop resize.
I feel like that's gonna be, this is about to get as sketch as fucking Garizmod gets. Cause I could use that exact tool to make pistons for my engine that fit perfectly.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
These are not staying here, they're just placement.
Yeah, cause that's got some breathing room. If I could, alright, how do I, alright, let me see what I do, hold on. Prop resizer. Do you have to physical scale and visual scale at the same time? Okay.
No, you can check the box. 110%?
Oh, you gotta do both directions. It fell through the ground. Oh,
how can
Jesus
I rotate
Christ.
Shit?
Is there a space?
That's how.
Is there a place for it to fall? Did it fall someplace where I could actually get to it? A prop may have just clipped through the ground and disappeared. If the server crashes, I apologize. I was resizing a sphere and it was like, nope. Okay, let me go back to the ball, the sphere. I think I was doing, what, 60s? So there's a 60 sphere at 110%. Oh, that's slightly not the one I need. Was 60 the sphere that I was putting in there? No, I don't think it was. No. I wonder what happens when you go... You can't go down, you can only go up, huh?
You can't go down. It starts at 1, but there's... You can go down to like 21.
I wonder if it's better to make big props smaller or small props bigger. See, this is another example of when you need a test rig to test all this shit out.
Blow your brains out, it's easier that way.
Let's see what 10% does. 10%'s too much.
Why are you in here, Chief?
8%.
I'm always here, baby.
But you're not in here.
There's no medic class in Garizmod, so he's taking a break.
There's no medic class, is that what you said?
Oh my god. That fixes so much. Alright, that like works perfectly. Now here's the question. Alright, who wants to... Can we please stop what we're doing? Can we resize a prop that is an entity? Because that's mildly important for what I want to do.
I'm gonna guess no.
Because My goal is to, instead of using a piston, change the sphere that I'm going to use as a piston to a wire weight, and then just attach to that. Oh, God.
Yes.
Jesus, God.
It's stuck.
I better do a full test of this. I better... All right, I need to get a wire weight model going. Wire weight tool.
There you go.
Wow, Dr. Nick, that's the minjury. Please don't tell Tricky this exists. Go away, Tricky. It doesn't exist.
Perfect.
There's no telling the fucking minjury.
Wait. Hold on.
Jesus Christ. Oh, it's stuck on my crane.
Oh my God. It's not stuck. It's just going as fast as the Jeep normally goes.
Oh my God.
Oh, please kick Dr. Nick now. I bought it quick. I'm inspired to build. Don't make him ruin it. Although,
yeah, Zeus is inspired. Like it's stuck on...
No.
All right. I need to know. Are you ready for this? Here, everyone's watching this recording in like 3 weeks. This has been one person. How do I do a console command for a wire weight for a particular model? Go.
GMOD tool, wire underscore tool, weight underscore weight, weight underscore mod.
All right, wire underscore tool underscore weight underscore model. All of that, and then a space, and then the model?
Wire underscore weight underscore model.
Wire underscore weight underscore model. Unknown command, wire underscore weight underscore model.
Let me look it up.
How do you spell?
W-E-I-G-H-T.
Okay, here. I'll help you. Go to your console and type...
I think, yeah, I spelled the word wire wrong.
Oh, God.
Alright, now I have to see if these will resize, and then I gotta save them. They totally resized. Oh, I could use make spherical on them too! Holy fuck! There's gonna be so many things.
Are you gonna make the angry eyebrow?
10.
Possibly.
What the fuck?
An angry visor? Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Does that not collide with anything? Oh no.
My truck doesn't have a visor, I'm kind of pissed.
What the fuck? Wire weight tool have a fucking option? Alright, well, something just ruined it because now these no longer can collide with anything. Does mixed spherical make it no collide at all?
That's sad.
Check a setting. I don't think it does it default.
Prop resizer.
Prop resizer didn't do it. Making it into entity might have done it.
Did you scale up the visual size or the physical size?
Doesn't matter. It doesn't have any collision point.
It should because it's got a physical fucking scale.
Scale visual with physical is checked.
Okay, and then you change the physical X scale, physical Y.
Everything is changed to 101.08%. Everything is slightly bigger. And now these are just, you can walk through them, so they don't, I didn't do that.
No, that's because wire weights are fucking no collide all.
Can I undo that?
Get your no collide tool out and right click.
It works. It's been a while, Dr. Nick, God. Wait a second.
Yeah, any kind of like wire entity like that, it's all no collide all. It's basically anything but like wheels and shit.
Why is the server lagging when I touch these? And why don't they fit now?
That's not for me.
Alright, I'm gonna have to change the size again, because now that I made them make spherical, they may be too big.
I'm gonna use a custom modifier on control.
You can probably use a custom model for almost anything with some console commands.
Wire tool prop, or wire tool. Wire pod controller, something like that. Copy.
Oh, maybe this is not doing anything because. Oh, it's locked in with the make spherical.
Boom. Ah, it's fucking not rotated, goddamn.
Yeah, no, it's locked in with the make spherical. Okay. So what I need to do is there's an order of operations here that I need to proceed with. Where I make wire weights that are these balls and then make them spherical and then make them larger. Because I could define the size by make spherical as well. Here you can do, well, here you can do the set radius. Offset center,
oh, neat.
Box center instead. Offset render. Okay, so I'm gonna undo all of these little balls right now. And there. So now we're gonna do a wired weight, which don't pick the model. Drop it down. We're gonna test one of these at a time. Alright, I have to make that collide. That's number one. Tools, no collide. So that's good. Okay, but it's too small. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make it spherical. Which, I shouldn't have to set anything. Just hit it. And then try dropping it in here again. Okay. She's still loose. And now we're going to go and we're going to set the radius. I'm gonna see. What's the size of the tube we're using? That's a 48. Let's set this to 50. Let's see if I can set it here. Then I don't have to resize the prop at all. Let's just go to 50 radius and see if that freaks it out. Still moves. 52 radius. Still jiggling. I want to get it to actually freak out so I know it's doing what I'm telling it to do. Nope, it doesn't seem to be doing what I'm telling it to do. Let's lift it up and just drop it back again. You know, I don't think the set radius on the make spherical works. Or this would be perfect.
I don't think you want to do that yourself anyways. You just want to use the...
No, but you don't understand what I'm doing. I'm trying to make these... I'm literally, these are going to be the cylinders for this giant engine, and that's the wired weight. And I want it to perfectly fit in this, but it's got a little bit too much jiggly room. So either I'm going to resize the prop with prop resizer or use the make spherical anyway and make it not have that much jiggle room. Because I could do it with a prop resizer, but if I could do it with... I'm going to do make spherical regardless.
Well, so the make spherical does work because I've done it with like a big prop. Because like, look, if I do this and I make this spherical...
Right, unless I have to do the make spherical with the define, maybe I can't update the, I may not be able to update the, what's it called, the make spherical. Can you update it after you've made it?
Are you, I don't know, are you, yeah you can. Are you right clicking?
No.
To do your, that's why.
It's a right click?
Yeah, right click sets the custom.
Oh,
look, there's my
yeah.
Custom right there.
That's put my picture of a dick on there. So let's set this back to 50.
Do you want me to quickly make one?
Tricky's got that down pat anymore.
Tricky is the king of dicks. Wow. Oh, radius. Oh, Jesus. No. I thought it was diameter. We got a 25. That's not the gun I'm gonna use. Much less wiggle room. So let's see. Let's bump it up to 26. I'm probably gonna have to go into like. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at it, baby. Look at it. It's so tight. Oh, it's so tight. I'm gonna superize this. It's gonna be fucking.
Well,
I probably put gravity back on.
This thing is back in the game. You missed.
Okay, so that's like the ultimate fucking cylinder ever, and. Remove all these, because I'm not doing anything. Remove. Balloon! Get used to it, boys and girls. Balloons are our friend. So now, that's a game changer right there. This should be the perfect physical cylinder. Because I'm using one less tool. I didn't have to do a property size. I could just make spherical on anything. I could have put a fucking baby in here, because it's just going to put a bounding box of a cylinder on it. I'm not putting a baby, by the way. I'm sorry. So check now I'm gonna have to limit it with like a rope limiter that just keeps it from flopping out of this thing. So what I need to do is I need to take that point two, and make it happen above this.
No.
And I have these. So I have to make it happen above it. So now I need to move a point. So now we're going to go back to precision alignment. And we're going to probably have to do the reload key. And we're going to have to go to points. And we're going to go to point two. And we're going to have to go... Z is up and down in this game, right? It's not stupid like Minecraft?
Not stupid like Minecraft. Yes.
Holy shit, that's very big. So let's go 200. 200.
Minecraft is the only game where Z isn't up and down.
Thanks, Notch. Okay, where did it go? My point. Point two. Oh, fuck. Is it going with the world? You motherfucker.
Oh. Yeah, that's what happened.
Don't worry about it.
It said the same thing. It didn't fucking, what's it called? Where it just said. So how do I figure out where the fuck... where's point one, then? I can find out where... How do I find out where... Fuck! Where the fuck are these points? Fucking piece of shit. Fucking... Why does it show me zeros if it's not at zero? I don't get it.
What's throttle?
There is none yet.
Somewhere above in the sky or below in the ground, that point moved. I just wanted to move it up a little bit.
I get the
parts. Bring that over. So now, how do I figure out where one is so I at least get a rough fucking estimate? Wait. I know what a rough fucking estimate is. I have it here. There you go. 7,750. Negative 7,750. So if I do this again, and I go to negative 7,750 point whatever, and set it, it should now be...
This already fucking feels smooth, and it doesn't even drive.
Somewhere. Nope. I don't see the point. Wait, oh, there's the point. What?
Up and we'll push it around.
Oh, you motherless cockbag and fucknutter. It literally moved the point to 0, 0. 7,000. It's in the middle of the map. That, it's just, I hate this. Good science going on here, boys.
This needs like an anti-roll bar.
You could do that by putting a prop between the wheels, like a skinny rod, then attaching ropes, rigid ropes, and then adjusting how welded that is to the body with just making the weight lighter and lighter and lighter. So it still flexes. That's how I would do a prop. Just put a make a physical fucking bar, yeah, and then weld it, and then you just keep lowering the weight until it flexes like you want it to.
Like you build a diff, you weld the diff to the axle, and you weld the diff to the body. And you change the weight down. So
hold on, we got puff.
The real Mandy emerges. Oh my god, it's too real.
But wait, are you back in college? Did you go back to college? Because you've got like ramen and bedhead. So I mean, I'm playing the Geary's mod with the boys. She's got the bedhead. So I gotta redo that point. Point two is I have to abandon point two because it's fucking done. And we're gonna go back to mass center on this boy. Fuck am I supposed to get? Copy? Values copy to clipboard. Fantastic. Relative to entity. Boom! This,
but if you want
to
make a
thank God. So there you go. So I just gotta make it relative to entity. And then I can go
wheel plates on the steer axle.
A bit.
Like Hiboto has here. Also,
and I can set it. Where did I go?
What do you mean?
Did I push it into the ground again?
Well, your wheels are going to pivot around the back of this plate instead of the front.
Oh, no, there it is. It's way too high. That's all.
Yeah, I'm aware.
That's okay. A lot too high.
I did that because in real life, like, technically the suspension's not mounted like that, but my wheel will rotate on the outside like that because of suspension components. That's why I did it like that.
That is... still too high. I could just push this up and down, but I just want to get it right once.
Like eight, no, I guess the brakes do take up most of the space inside the...
Yeah.
That's not bad, actually. That's what's moving.
Yeah, you could do it.
So now we're going to right-click that prop, and we're going to go point one to point two.
And then, I've got a steering expression.
There you go. We now have a fucking cylinder perfectly located over that.
The set angle shit.
And
yeah,
what I'm probably going to end up
doing
is that 10 times. Because I could try to stacker this over, but it's never going
to
be perfect.
I'm
going to
try to do I guess I'll take it.
So what I'm going to do is now...
The way I do it is I have a solid axle for the steering axle.
I need 10 of those tubes. Those are...
The solid
48 by tubes normal, 48 by 96.
That way whatever angle the chassis
six,
at, this thing does its math off of that.
70, no, not 72, 48.
Gotcha. Off to 48
by 90, 48 by 96.
Take a peek at this here.
I'm going to double check this by literally holding it up.
It's even got variables for like your top speed, steering angle.
Doesn't look the same. Nope, I'm using a bigger size. Huh. 60 by 90.
Entity set 96. Angle chassis.
Weird because I'm using a 50 diameter prop. I thought it was 48. Oh well. Bigger cylinders the better. Is that the right height? Are we good? Do we find our lovely match? Alright.
Interesting.
So what I'm gonna do now, because I'm too lazy to spawn a bunch of those and have them be frozen and everything. Is we're just gonna spawn.
I've saw some of these and I was like tempted to use them. And I was like, I don't wanna cheat that hard.
I've got one,
go
I've got two.
School.
I do eight more.
Once I do it like once or twice, completely
reset,
old school.
Reset
so,
that. We're not gonna weld. We're not gonna no collide, although the no colliding wouldn't matter. We're gonna freeze them. What? By the way, the ghosting of stackered props makes fucking noise. It's hysterically terrible.
Mine doesn't do that.
Oh, Jesus Christ. What is that?
You may already have it.
Easy car steering. I didn't mind the number of the fucking. Damn. I like it. That's saved. Save. Appreciate that. I didn't fucking remember the fuck. Let me see if it's still in the tool. Maybe I don't have to like worry about it. I should have made it a very specific number that's easy to remember in the tool. And I didn't do it. So let's see if I go in here. Great. 813.
So how is this going to drive your boat?
How is this going to drive my boat? Well, hold on. This is going to make torque. It's going to come to the backside of the dock here where there will be a fucking cacophony of geared transfers that will rotate. So it's going to drive straight, and then the gear on the bottom is going to turn, and then the other gears will rotate with the boat position. And it should transfer the motion to the boat. Or transfer the rotation to the boat. So it'll just be free moving. Just like this right here is free moving. If I let that boat go, this will just spin. This, essentially, but those gears being attached to a gear on the floor. Alright, it needs to stop bouncing around now. So it should work. And then as an industrial motor, this will just be insane. I need to remember this number. Hold on. Because I fucked up. 8,000. Copy. Actually, I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to do Y. And then I'm going to do that. Boom. Remembered. Can't believe I didn't fucking... Just... It could have been 8111 or 810. But no. Actually, that is a little high. I probably could reposition this. And I think I could reposition it without... I think I could just attach a point to this. Hold on.
We'll be on hopefully tomorrow.
And it's already selected.
Cool.
But where do I move it to? I need a second point to move it to. That's the problem. Because that's point one, and I had... What's the button we hit to pick the second point in our... What we're doing, precision alignment?
You mean to make a new one?
Hold yeah, shift. Like hold shift. Is that what it is? Nope, that's not what it is.
What are you trying to do?
I just want to be able to click point one, point two, point three.
Control? Like every other program ever made?
Nope, it just keeps moving the same point over. I have to go to the menu, click point two, and then click again. Now I can go 0.2, and then I can make this a fucking number that isn't stupid. And then I can move... Did I make 0.2 higher? Shit, I made 0.2 higher, didn't I? I wanted my 0.2 slightly lower. Oh god, it's all fucked up now. No, yes. Why is relative to entity versus relative to world? I gotta go 8200 set. I don't care which what it is. It just as long as it's 8200's too low. It's gotta be halfway between that. 8150. Set. Okay, let's try that and let's move the entity. Boom. Oh, I gotta reverse this. Boom. Okay. 8150. That's a little more compact. It should be fine with the stroke length. Now we're ready to start deleting points. Jesus Christ. Fuck, it's fine, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. We're gonna right click to get rid of that. And now so our point one, and I could probably do like all of these points, but I'm not gonna. And then I gotta do. Oh, I have to like freeze this. I should probably freeze all of these. They're just spinning around like. Oh. Why is that one? Why are you not? Oh, it's rotated enough that it's not in sync anymore? Because these are, like, in sync. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. I guess I could just freeze it. It doesn't have to be, like, exactly in sync. As long as it's... As long as they're meshing in the right spot. It's only that one that's doing the weird... Odd. I'll just keep an eye on that, that's all. Okay, back to what I was doing. Precision alignment. Points, murder. So there's point one. I have to click point two because I don't know how to make it auto. How do I make it auto go to point two? Point two. We select that prop. We go here. We want to move point two to 8150. Oh, God. Relative to entity. Then take it off. And then take it to 8150. Of course, we need to, or also to push it back over where the other one is. It's 8150. Set. Close. It looks like it's in the correct position. And then we're moving point one to point two. Move. Undo. That is, that's two done. And now we have to delete all, and this is gonna, you know what, I'll save you guys some time and I'll pause the fucking recording. Holy shit. Are we back at this? 56 minutes, Jesus Christ. This is a whole new thing for me, like with OBS and the future and a million hard drives, and I only have 40 megabit uploads now, so it's not like I have, oh God, this is gonna take forever to do. So I got all these in position, and actually it took like a couple minutes. I showed.
All right, I'll be back in a bit. When I brought up what was going on, and watch some TV for a minute.
This is better than TV. So I'm just placing these plates here temporarily. Although I could put them there permanently. In fact, it wouldn't be the worst idea. But I could put them back later, like the whatever rods. Threw a rod. I threw a rad. Will don't care like that there's a plate there because it's going to be a rope that doesn't interact with anything. I changed the colors. I made these 50,000 weight. I welded them to the bottom. I duped it because I hadn't duped it yet. I made them slightly transparent, which is sort of making them look weird as I move around. And now we're going to do more of these. So we now need wire weights. And I'm just going to drop them down. That's why these plates are here. Because I'm just going to fill every cylinder with its corresponding thing. So we go wire, we go weight, adjustable. We need, that's one, here's two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, oh Jesus Christ, ten. And I say oh Jesus Christ because that one's clipping into that one. And we're going to do two things right now. No, one thing. We're just going to make spherical. That's it. We go tools. We go make spherical. We have our custom radius of 26. We right click to set our custom radius. We're going to make them super ice with gravity because I'm not sure how wire weights... Wire weights can have no gravity and they just become mass. But we're going to use the gravity of the actual game. Oof. We're going to use the gravity of the actual game to pick these, to actually push down. So there is our, there's, look how little that, I've superized all the cylinders already. So we have just the slightest bit, like it's not binding, it's just, it's very happily spinning in its place. So now all of them are going to get one of those. What the fuck just, oh, I forgot to do a thing. Oh, where did it go? Oh, Jesus Christ. Where did it go? Is it no collide with the Earth? What the fuck? Did it no collide with the Earth? Like, I just... Because I didn't do the no collide thing. That was another thing I had to do while I was on the fucking ground. Yeah, no, it's just... It's got nothing. Where the fuck did it go, though? So if I can't find it, then I'm gonna have a loose fucking wire weight. I don't understand. Alright. We're just gonna... I could either undo all these and redo them all, or I could just want another wire weight. This is the... Oh god, this is fine. Physical properties. Make spherical. Oh, I did this in a different different order, because the other ones make spherical. And then I did the thing. And then I gotta go no collide, and I gotta... The first one I put in was the first one that I had already tested to make them collidable. Old Zeos would have put any amount of music on. I would be rocking it right now. Yeah, that one's fine. Okay. Make sure it hits the sides before you let it go. That's what I'm saying. I wonder if this is possible on a much, much smaller scale. Now that I'm thinking about it. For like an actual car's motor. I miss listening to music while playing GarageBand. I guess I could in my headphones. And you wouldn't hear it. And I mean, I don't want to force people to listen to music, but actually I do, which is why my sound demos are even a thing. And I don't have to keep these upright or anything, because they're allowed to spin as ever the fuck they want. I could ball socket them to the base plate just to keep their orientation, but I don't need to. It's a sphere in a cylinder. Just let it free flow. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to do 180 degree rotations, which I may have to adjust this gear if it's not. Because I'm going to... Oh, there it is. Oh, my baby ball. I'm so sorry. I thought I lost you. I have to remove you now because I made a new one. Oh, I feel so bad. Balloon. I think what I... Well, I need... I have to have a rope. The rope tool will not do what I need to have done. And Hiboto just left. So I may have to figure this out on my own. So the goal is... And I have to test this over here. I should have left that weight. We'll just test it with the wire weight over here. We'll do another one. My goal is... And I don't have to make this one special or anything. There's that. Let me spawn a gear. Just any gear. Mechanics. There you go. Big gear. Stand it up. I'll put this above it. We're going to do a little test. Because I need to be able to make the ropes magically go from the center of the sphere. Because it's something you can't do in GarageBand. Like, I can't take out the rope tool and say, be in the direct mass center. But you can, with precision fucking alignment, you can do that. This tool is fucking weird. So I could do center of hit. Actually, you know what? I am going to... make sphere click, because I want to make sure I have all the constraints that I possibly could have. No collide on, physical property ice. Okay, so now that's basically another ball like we have over there. Does it hit the gear? It does. Doesn't have to be directly above, but it just needs to be like there, because before I do it to that, I need to do it to this. And what I'm going to end up doing is precision alignment. We are going to do point one, which will be the center of the ball. Oh god. Hit position? Mass center? Alright. Mass center worked. I wanted to make sure. What about bounding box center? Same spot. Coordinate center? Same spot. So I'll do mass center. Because sometimes that changes depending on the shape of your prop, if it's wanky as fuck. That's spot one. And now spot two. I guess I'm good. It's easiest to just do that. And now that's not on the edge. That's dead center of the prop. But I need to move that up, because you can't have the crank attached to the middle. So I need to move part two up using this. And the way I figure to do it is you do point two, take off, turn on. So now we got to figure out exactly how far to move it. And we're in the negatives. So, if I make this 25 and it's set, that's too high. I could actually have the rope be outside the gear. That's another thing. You could have it just be outside the gear. 35? And this is just a test, so 40 is what it's going to probably end up being for that, for this particular one. So, there's that. If that's at the top of the stroke, I'll have to do all of them at the bottom of the stroke, actually. because all the balls are sitting at the bottoms of the cylinders. So it's just going to be move the point down and then attach. And then at the top of the stroke, it'll be up. So for now, though, like, this doesn't really make a fun. I'm going to do it. Yeah, I'll do it. Fine. So we need to make that higher. So we need to make that, like, 80. 90? Oh, how easy it is to move that point. So, okay, there's 90. That's close enough to the edge. So now, how do I make rope go? It should just be under constraints. Ball socket available while it lasts like a rope. A rope. Force limit none. Add length none. Width thick as fuck, boy. Like, we got some big ass shit over there. So let's make it like 15. And set length 0. Rigid, we definitely want on. Between 0.1 and 0.2. Create constraint. Not that. Oh, okay, I fucked it up. I gotta undo the rope with the rope tool, though. I think I can do that. And then I can go back to... You don't want it to be the color of a rope. That's dumb. So that. Boomp. Boomp. We should now have a free spinning... Yep, and it's attached at the perfect point on the gear. There is our crank, and the ball will literally drag behind it and rotate. Alright, our test was a success. There is a crank, a cylinder, and a piston. So, now, let's do that 10 fucking times. But, let's add the enjoyment of having to rotate the gears 180 degrees so I could do the other side, because the balls are both sitting at the bottom. So I'm going to do this side, and each one of these five pairs is going to be... I'm going to time them individually, and then I'm going to rotate them 72 degrees and go, okay, 0, 72, 144, whatever the hell the next number is. And this way the gear... Because I'm worried about the strain on the gears. You don't want to have this one firing, and then 10 degrees later, this one firing. Or this one, and then 72 degrees later, this one firing. These have to be 180 degrees apart. And then these have to be 72 degrees apart, and 72 degrees apart, and 70, from each other. So that's what we're doing. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to check. See, that's no good. They need to be able to be rotated. I mean, I guess I could just rotate this one 180 degrees, and then we're good. But I'm pretty sure one of these should, like... See if that was it. Nope, it's still not doing it. So the way to fix this, and I hate doing this because I just hate doing it, is to actually no collide the gears with each other, or no collide that one with everything by right clicking it. Straighten this out to where you want it to be. And then straighten this out to where you want it to be. And then pray that when you do that, you've taken off the no collide. Because you never can tell with Gary's mod. It looks like it's worked. Okay. So now that could be locked in place. And these should all be roughly vertical. Good, good. These are off by 45 degrees. Good, good. And those are good. Frozen, frozen. Frozen, frozen. Frozen, frozen. Yes, yes. So now, I drink some water, because this is getting there. Pasta messaged me on Steam. One second. Shift tab. How the F do you get out of Beat? Can you play Beat Saber, you motherfucker? Oh god, I have to buy it with your credit card. Do... Get the F out of here so I can play Beat Saber, you motherfucker. Oh, because I was playing Gary's mod, and she was in the... She's, I gotta yell at her now. Hold on, I gotta yell at her on the phone. Wait, at 8 o'clock you tried to play Beat Saber? I didn't notice your name flashing in the corner for 2 hours, because Gary's mod. It's my first love, baby, you understand. But anyway, did you buy Beat Saber with my credit card? You're welcome. shut that off. So now we need to do... I'll probably do the first set and then pause the video again because we're at an hour and 10 minutes already, and then do the other sets. I should have a different channel for this because Pasta's going to be like, why do you keep uploading these videos to the thing? Well, it's because it was the original, the gaming channel. Oh my God, look at the... Oh, the beauty of that. Oh, they're all lined up in the row. Oh, my pee-pee. My pee-pee so hard. They won't be when I go to time them against each other, so this is the last chance you're going to get to see that. So, clear all the points. Delete all points. Point one, I made the ball, so we'll do the point one on the ball. Mass center. These plates are doing a good job of holding them basically all the same. Point two, mass center there. Now we got to move the mass center that we just picked down, and I don't know how far. So let's move here so we get a good visual of it. I'm pretty sure I can go all the way, like ICP would say. Let's go all the way. Let's go all the way. That's in the wrong thing. I need to go back to points. Two, relative, on and off. So now we basically take this. If we do the relative to entity, it goes to zero. No, it doesn't anymore. We're going down. So we need to go like, what are we at? 872? 8272. Let's go to 8150. 8172. Let's just try that. Set. Oh, wrong way. So 8372? Way too far. Let's go back to 8272, which is the center. Okay. So which way the fuck are we going? Hold on a second. Yeah, okay, 82, 92. So we gotta go to like 8, 3, 10. Ooh, that's right at the edge. Now, the longer the crank, like we're actually determining the crank, the throw of the piston right now. The longer it is, the slower, I mean, it's gonna be slow already, so I can put it there. I think I'm just gonna make it 300. That's not bad. Because right now we're going to have a crank that goes from there to there. And that is like middle. It's not quite outside the gear. I could get a little bit more out of it. I get like 5 more units out of it. Because we have that much room to do. The more it moves, the farther it moves, the slower it has to go to be stable. But we'll also get more power out of it. The shorter it moves, the faster it can go, but we get less power out of it. Oh, fuck it. We're doing 8300 even, I think. What's 8310 do? Too far. All right, 8305. I'm settling on it. 8305, everybody. That's all we got to remember is 8305. Jesus, I'm never going to remember that. Okay, so now we're just ready to go to the
fill me up.
Constraint setting. We're going to go to the constraint setting. We're going to do the exact same thing. I was pretty happy with 15, but let's go to 18 on that rigid rope. You know I love it. Rigid, points 1 to point 2. Create constraint. Close this. We now have a rope on the ball or in the ball. We've got a big ass fucking rope that is an entity, so it doesn't actually have mass. It just is seen. It goes into the prop down to there at the bottom of the stroke. So now what I've got to do is I've got to unfreeze that and I got to rotate this 180 degrees. Oh God, what just happened? That ball isn't frozen, is it? How much does that wire weight weigh? It should weigh like 5. No. There. So now we have that at the maximum top stroke. Holy fuck. I think maybe that's too much stroke. Okay. I'm going to do this. And we're going to do that again. Because that is too much stroke. Holy Jesus. So now I should still be able to just go in here and go to the fucking points. And then I just want to just point two. Yeah, no, let's do 8,300. Bring it up that little bit. Maybe I might have to go up even more. Because unless I make it stick out the bottom. If I... Do I want to constrain it completely to the thing or have it pop up a little bit? I guess we're going to have to just test it every time. Fuck it. Fuck it. Fuck it. We'll just make it a little bit less. I want to do this right. 295. 295. 8295. Set. Constraints. Rope. Ready. Set. Okay. Rotate. What are you being a piece of shit for, Ball? Oh, there it is. Now she's near. Yep, she's basically at the top. So that's 295 is gonna get it to do. We'll give it a full. You know, I could go a little bit more than that. I feel like that's basically perfect. You know, that's basically perfect. Okay, so now we take our points, we delete all our points, we start adding our other points back with this at 180. So that's at the top and that's at the bottom of the stroke. There's 0.1 mass center. There's 0.2 mass center. We go into the menu. We go to points. We go to 0.2. We go to set relative entity. And we go to 8295. 8295. Set. It lowers it down. We go to constraints. We go to create constraint. Boom. We got some ropes. It looks perfectly straight to me. Let's unfreeze this ball. Unfreeze this. Unfreeze this. Now these should just spin perfectly like that. So while one is up top, one is going down. So now I'm going to literally do that four more times. And then once I've done that, I'll unpause the video again and we'll continue along on this journey. You know, I pause it and then it's like, it's literally 3 minutes to do this because I'm not speaking and I'm not explaining things. So now every one of these is an independently running insano fucking piston driven sucker fuck. Now there's no timing between it because we have to now do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the crank position of this first one to the top and freeze it. And then I'm going to mark it with my favorite thing. It's an eyeball just right at the top. And I'm going to do the same for all of these. More 45 there. And we gotta make sure it's at the top and not the bottom because it's gonna be hard to tell. We should also be able to check with well, we should literally have all the balls on top on the right hand side, which we do. And then we just switch to something that shows us the grid lines, make sure all those are straight. I'm just painting it so that I can visually verify that what I'm doing is bringing top dead center around 72 degrees because we about to do that shit. Now, my only fear with this is using precision to rotate, because this one's going to stay at the top dead center, and then I'm going to rotate 1, 2, 3, 72 degrees right, 72 degrees right, 72 degrees right. Which actually, the way I should do this is this one, and no, it doesn't make a difference. Because you could do like 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, and then you'd have... No, it shouldn't make a difference. It probably doesn't make a difference. It might make a difference. Because you don't have firing order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's always 1, 8, 4, 3, 9, 2. Like, the weird shit. because you don't want the pressure, the full pressure on this going down. While this is also having the full pressure go down, you have too much weight on the crank on this side. So it would be beneficial to alternate one, two, but that's going to make timing it a nightmare. Like, I have to remember which order they fire in, although I'm probably going to get there and do it individually. We're just going to go straight on the line for sanity's sake. So now I got to make it 72 degrees. We got to do rotate, not 22 and a half. We got to do 72 degrees, not 4,000 either. 72 degrees. Freeze target. That's it. That's all we're setting. And my worry is it's going to spin this really fast. And we've got a gear interaction going on, and the wire weights don't weigh anything right now. But if something skips, in fact, you know what? I'm going to take out my fucking my paint tool again. And we're just going to make sure that I could see if the fucking things fuck up visually. Because there's no way to undo it. Either way, I'm going to be like no colliding and reposition the gears. I just want to have a way to do it, because gears are real hard to read. So I guess we'll just start precision. And I'm going to go clockwise, I believe. That's it. Oh, it didn't take the gear. It didn't take the other gear. Okay. New plan, everybody. New fucking plan. I have to freeze all the gears and rotate them both at the same time. Or we're going to have a bad time. Because it literally just makes the prop go, up. Oh, it's rotated. And it doesn't matter for the piston, but it matters for the gear to the side of it. So, precision, rotate right, and then precision, rotate left. And now, precision, rotate right once, twice. I'm going to have to move my mouse very far to make this thing kick off. Once, twice, and then precision. Well, I could actually go twice this way, because it's the same thing. Precision, out, out. And then I just have to do the precision left one. Well, I could do it from this side. Once, and once. So, that should be, let's see, top, right, there, there, and there. So that looks correct. And let's check the other side. Top, there, 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 and there. Okay, I'm going to now, I'm going to basically take the center gear, weld left, weld all the way left, weld right, weld all the way right, weld here, weld here, weld here. That should cover. I mean, easy weld used to weld all the constraints. I'm just making sure that they're all coherent. I probably don't need to do this many. Like, this might be enough. But I'm going to. Did I do that on that side? One, two, three, four, five, six. Like, you can't, like, do a weld over and over and over and over again. It just counts as one. I'm just making sure I've connected all of the entities that are spinning with all the other entities. And if you fuck this up, you can just hit reload weld and all the welds will disappear anyway. So this would be a great chance to hit reload weld, which reload freeze, which would unfreeze everything, but then the whole thing falls out of the sky. Let's make this go a little bit faster. Two. If you follow it down this, I'm pointing at my screen. If you follow down this first line, you can see. I'll get this to go faster again. No, you're not gonna respond. See, it's just going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's chasing it with the other one. So we've officially now got the physical ready to fuck you motor going. So the next step of this, hey, I'm going to freeze all these gears again. Because we're going to duplicate the shit out of this. The next step is the fun part, which is the wiring part, which is the stuff I haven't done in forever, which is the stuff that I actually went back in time. I dug through my fucking save dupes from like 2008, and I found all of the E2s I used to use. So everything is attached, because if you don't have a constraint, if you put something there and you don't have it like welded or ball socket or no collider or something, it will not take it. You also want to make sure you don't have extra shit. Like, if this thing I was testing with somehow was spawned off of it or no collided off of it, it would come with me, and I don't really want it to. Save. So let's see. What did I actually call the last one? 2020 Weight Engine V. What's the point of it popping up if I can't? What is the point? What the fuck? Weight engine V2. No description. Okay. So, put that away. Happy balloon goes away. I could remove these plates. These plates did not do because they're not attached to anything. Nor are they actually functional right now. Because, I mean, I may put something similar back later on. Because my worry is that the wire weights might... If they deform the gears enough with the pressure to make that ball come out, because we have it pretty fucking solid. It's just touching everything. Hold on. If those weights push down far enough to come out of those tubes, because we're not having them come down very fucking far. Like, that was my thing. I didn't mind if it came out the top. It's not going to fly out the top. But if it comes out the bottom, we have got a problem. We as a society have a problem. Oh, it's going to be so good. It's going to be so good once I get this thing actually going. Oh, God. My GMOD penis is so fucking hard right now. Because, I mean, I'm the master engine builder. I've always been the master engine builder. And people have built smaller engines and maybe smoother engines. But it's like, oh, there's just an art to this that I need to be the one that does it. I have to be the one that knocks. Let's make those pistons not ugly because they're disgusting. Should I make them like some sort of weird, like, glowing entity? Can I not? What is going on here? Oh my god. It's like it's powered by meatballs. I don't actually like that. I just did it because it was funny. I got these weird, like, non-textures that don't work. I don't know what those are doing. What about the emergency? Like, hold on. I have a, I do yellow balls. Just yellow balls. White balls, checker balls, warning balls. Oh, I like the warning balls. They're a little bit strange because the orientations are going to change, but I could do this and then paint them red on top of it. That's always fun. Or hugger orange because it's a Chevy. Color, absolutely not see-through. Absolutely orange, maybe a little bit... darker orange. That's fine, because as it's rubbing against the side, if it starts rotating the ball, or the weight ball, we'll be able to see it actually do that. In fact, you can see this one sort of rotating a little bit. Oh my god. The fact that we're not even hearing any, like, sounds, because it's just perfectly sliding smoothly up and down. What was the weight we actually picked on these? 600. Oh, that's not going to work. Let's crank those up to 7,500. I don't want to go 50K on the gears, but I'm going to be pushing down 50,000 weight. Because I mean, I could set it to anything I want. And I could increase the torque. Because these wired weights are just going to... Whatever they weigh, right? They weigh 24. Until I don't want them to weigh 24. Shit, I should have made sure that fucking worked. Shouldn't I have? Holy fuck. Let's make sure that works. So let's bring you over here. That would ruin my whole night would be ruined and we would just stop playing. This would be the last thing I do on this video anyway, right? Like an hour and a half. Why is everything so small? There we go, that's a manly gear. So I'm just gonna weld this to this. That's frozen. I'm gonna unfreeze this. What does this gear weigh? 100. And what do you weigh? 24. So let me just do this yank. Let me see if I can deform that gear with a weld. Yeah, right. You see how I could, like, just yank it and that gear, like, gives up a little bit? So let's see. If I wire an advanced input, or not even an advanced input, just an input, just a numbered input, and we're going to go value off is 1 and value on is 50,000. And that's the space bar. Space bar. Click off of that motherfucker. And we're going to put that right there. And then I'm going to take the wire tool, and we're going to wire this thing. What do I want the weight to be? And now the weight should be settable. It says the weight's 1. Oh yeah, look at that fucker sag. Let's switch inputs. Oh yeah, 50,000. There she goes. She's just dragging that welded gear around like it's its bitch. But if I shut it off, it weighs nothing. But then it weighs 50,000. That's what this motor, that's the principle this motor is going to run on, is that if you could just magically make the cylinders weigh more than they do. So look, just let it all go. It's fine. Fuck. Fat boy Slim is fucking in heaven. Alright. Well, my test rig here is working perfectly. I'm going to undo that controller, so it doesn't fuck up the rest of my life. I'm gonna actually... Can I alt-tab and get text and then come back in? I think that'll work, right? So let me go to the GMOD thing where I posted a fuck ton of my codes yesterday. Where is it? Engine. ZP's tank steering. Thrusters, hydro steering, gate name, convertible, sound controller, angular force. There we go. V8 engine, which I'm going to have to modify to make it a V10 engine. Copy text. Come back into game. Be careful because I just touched when I alt-tab, I touch. And if I touch that, that will unfreeze. And that would not be good if that unfroze. That's all of this is attached to that. So let's not look at that. Let's go back to the wire. Oh, actually, I have to stand this up straight, because the way this should work, if this E2 still works, which I'm going to change the E2 model to something that's not terrible. Shit, why is it that model? I don't want it to be that model. Easy car steering. No, I want a new model. Model size, normal, nano. Fuck! I can't... I'm locked into that as my E2. I don't want that to be my E2. Oh, God. Add to favorites. Oh, shit, I could... Add that to... Alright, first of all, favorites is spelled wrong. There's no U in favorites. Can we just agree? Please, everybody? Beacon sensor... Speedometer, weight tool, add that to favorites. Even though it's spelled wrong, you'd be fucked. Advanced input, favorites. Dual input, favorites. Numpad input, favorites. Button constant value, lever, no. Weld constraint is favorites. Hydraulic. Yep, let's put a hydraulic in there. Oh, Jesus, I let go of the thing I was trying to scroll wheel. Wire forcer, add that to favorites. I'm sorry, I'm adding this to favorites on your time. Clutch, explosive, gimbal, weight, definitely at... No, I removed that from favorites. I just removed the weight tool. Add to favorites. And then the fucking... Did I do thruster? Wait, I did weight. I don't know if I did thruster. hoverball motor forcer. Yeah, add that to favorites. And then the actual fucking debugger tool and the wire tool. So now I should only need these and not everything fucking else in wire mod. Please go away. So, fans of a debugger, dual input, expression 2. Expression 2. Why is this my fucking model? God damn it, Dr. Nick! Dr. Nick! Hey, Bodo! Jeez! Yes, my push and talk sounds of Ventrilo are the button sounds. So, if I can't pick a different, like, model, like, it's just not allowing me to pick it, I guess I have to, new expression. Maybe if I do new expression, it will... Hey, look, that worked. Persist trigger. Wow, this is old, because trigger's not even on this thing. And I was running an interval of 5. So, name, inputs, outputs, persist trigger. Name, inputs, out. So I could delete the ones. This is my basic engine thing. Outputs angle, which is fine because it's an internal thing of the angle equals what it is. Save as V8 engine. Okay. It's saved. It looks like it's up. Oh, there's a... It quoted it from somewhere. Let's try that. There you go. Now we'll save that again. Yes. Sound browser. Am I getting recorded? What's happening? Hold on a second. Oh, Jesus Christ. Thank God that it's really sunny there so you can't see that. I gotta put this somewhere else. Hold on. Somewhere where you guys can't see it. Perfect. Accidents happen. Expression 2. I don't even see a fucking chip anymore. Oh, there it goes. Switched back. Thank God. So we got mini and normal. I guess I'll do normal. It'll just be easier to hit, and I don't mind if it's visual. So basically what this chip does is it looks at its own orientation and rotation. And that's how we time the engine. And it should take into account the world as well without putting anything external. I mean, this isn't moving. So as long as I could debug this... And we see the angle is 360 degrees. So let's give it a spin. Yep, there we go. 270. Oh, God, 90. No, no, no. It's not good. It's not doing the right... Oh, it's not doing the right orientation. I have to modify the chip. It's a 270, 90. Fuck. E2. Back into it. Angle equals entity angle roll. So, either I detach the chip and rotate it, or I figure out how to fix this, and I don't know how to fix it. Honest to God. Like, that's above my pay grade. Like, it's just, there's nothing even to change. Unless... Entity, angle, roll, plus 180. Alright, let's, you know what we'll do? Here's what we'll do. Wait till this gets back to zero. Which there's angles 352, 357, whatever. Freeze this, get the weld tool out, unweld just the chip, not the whole fucking thing. Pull it off. Alright, now which way is it actually measuring the angles? Because we can go this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, this is the way it wants to be. So it wants to be flat like that. And then it measures... And then what's this? So the bottom up is 0 or 360. And then as you rotate, 330, 320 up in the corners. So basically what I need to do is I need to go and mount this fucking thing to the fucking... like this. I need to just shove it in there like a goddamn breakfast cracker. I don't know why breakfast cracker, but that's what I just said. So shut up. I mean, it's not gonna be any stress on it. It doesn't matter. It's just that stupid looking. But you know what? Life's stupid sometimes, and we just gotta get our business done. So now, yes, we have the correct counting from 360. So we get this one to the top dead center, and we have to adjust it also. How much time we got? Hour 40? We got 5 minutes before. Hour 45 is like a good amount of time to be in a GarageMod video. So what we're going to end up doing is we're going to also do D. Actually, we're going to do... We're going to change this quite a bit. Because with the way this is designed, it's... And it shouldn't be a V8, not with three firing orders. This is a V6. Why is it called V8? This is like a V6, because you only got three different bank angles of firing and not firing. We're going to actually need 10 different bank angles. We're going to need all of them. We're going to need all of them. We're going to need D and E. We're going to need at least 5. We won't need more than 5, because each set is 180 degrees. One goes, then the other goes on the other side. So we're literally timing for 5 and not this many. And then the power input is literally an advanced input that would multiply for the output. So A, B, C, D, and E are what's getting sent to the weight tool. So power is going to be how much weight times what. So it should be interesting. Because as soon as it hits the top of the stroke, we're not doing... Oh, also not doing -1. Because that would be thrust down or don't thrust down. What we're going to do is we're going to do x0. Which, oh, you can't times by 0. Because the weight can't be... Okay. Off has to be 1. And on has to be a different variable. Which is pressure. Which is press. Because we can't go to 0. So we need to make a persistent value that's called press. And then we're going to define that persistent value. I don't know like where to define it. At the bottom, at the top. This is all new. It's always new to me. Press equals... what's a good fucking number that's bigger than 1? 2,000. Because we're still multiplying whatever the answer is times the power input. So it would just be 0 to 25, and then 25 would become the maximum of 50,000 weight. So it'll be either the balls will weigh 1 or the balls will weigh 2,000 at the lowest amount of power. Yes. So on, off, on, off. How do we stop this motor, though? It's multiplied by Z. Because with a thruster, you're using thrust. With a weight engine... I guess once all the balls weigh exactly the same, like they do now, it'll stop. When the balls have different weights, when the one that is traveling downward weighs 50,000, it's moving. The ones that are traveling up weigh 1, or whatever the light, whatever I decide to. 1 might be a little bit too, like maybe I should make it not 1, but like 100. Actually, you know what? I could change press to HEV. HEV, HEV. And I'll change the other one to light, L-I-T. Heavy and light. This way we define that, and so it makes more sense. Hev and light are defined inside the thing. L-I-T, and we get rid of press. H-E-V. Okay, so heavy and equals, like, I don't know. This way I could just change one value and it fixes everything. So... 500. So when the piston's off, instead of just weighing 1, it'll weigh 500. And I could always just stretch it out. So I could actually probably control the RPMs by, instead of having go 50,001, it could go 25,000, 10,000, 25,000, 10,000. Keep the mass there. Keep the momentum from the weight, but not have it be such a great difference. Instead of going 1, 15,000, you can do 10, 25,000. It might slow it down. I don't know. We'll find out. But I got to add a next level. And this one's extra long because It's where we go past the thing. So our angles have to be updated. Heavy and light need to be updated from this. Because we're all just negative 1-1, so it's going to be heavy, light, times power. I'm going to copy that. Question mark, heavy, light, times power. Heavy, light, times power. So these are all now updated to use this new system. And then times power, power is still our input. Power would still have to go 0 to 25. If it's at 0, it's at 0. Times 0, whatever you times by 0, is nothingness. Well, it'll never go to nothingness because it'll never be 0. Everything will just go to the light weight of 500. I think. That's what we're going to try to work out. So now, it's a matter of actually timing the engine. So, yeah. I think I'm going to end this and possibly start another one. Or maybe I'll just stick around with this because it's just a matter of finding out the angles and putting angles in here. 0 to 180 works absolutely perfect for row number 1. Actually, we need E, right? We need E. Put that there. Copy this. And I can always trim away the extra fat on these. Because some of these are not going to need it. 0 to 180, 180 to 360 is going to be fine. Heavy light, heavy light. I'll work this out. I'm going to work this out in my brain. I'm going to validate this. I'm going to upload it and exit. See, the problem is I can't upload it and not exit. It doesn't make any sense. I just want to upload it. Yeah. Because I'm about to get into it, boys and girls. I'm about to get into it good.